Anderson Cooper 360, weeknights at 8 and 10 on CNN.
A Philadelphia judge today refused to dismiss murder charges against a fundamentalist Christian couple whose infant son died from pneumonia. When their baby got sick in April, Herbert and Catherine Scheibel didn't call a doctor or seek any kind of medical treatment. They prayed. This case would be tragic even if the facts ended there, but they don't. This is not the first time the Scheibels have been charged in the death of one of their children. They've relied on faith healing before with disastrous results. Here's Gary Tuckman.
At this North Philadelphia cemetery, most of the graves are marked, but not this spot, where two small children are buried. Two children who would be alive today, say authorities, if their parents gave them medical care. Herbert and Catherine Scheibel are charged with third-degree murder following the death of their 8-month-old son, Brandon, this spring.
Instead of caring and nurturing him, they ultimately cause his death by praying over his body instead of taking him to the doctor.
And unbelievably, this isn't the first time this has happened to the Scheibels. In 2009, their 2-year-old son, Kent, died. The parents did not seek medical care to treat him.
I tried the previous case 2.5 years ago, and the circumstances to that case, to this case, are eerily similar.
In the first case, the Scheibels were found guilty of involuntary manslaughter and the death of Kent. The prosecutor asked for prison time, but the judge instead opted for probation and allowed the couple to move back to their home with their 7 other children. The judge did order them to seek medical care for their children in the future. Joanne Pescatore prosecuted the case then and will prosecute this case as well.
When the judge gave probation, you must have been very upset at the time.
I was upset. I was upset at that, and I was upset because I felt that they just didn't get it and they weren't going to get it. And now here we are standing here again 2.5 years later. Another one of their children is dead and they still don't get it.
Which is why they've been charged with a more serious count of third-degree murder this time around for the death of their baby Brandon. So what's with these parents? Authorities point to Philadelphia's first century gospel church, where the Scheibels belong, a church that declares its trust in God alone for physical healing.
This church lists many of its core philosophies on its website. Relevant to this case is one particular belief that I will quote in part. If we are trusting in pill prescription or medication, Satan is able to hinder our victory from God.
So why is this type of faith healing preached? We wanted to talk to the church's pastors.
Hi, my name is Gary Tuckman with CNN.
The daughter of the chief pastor said he did not want to speak with us.
How are you? Good, is the pastor home?
The wife of the assistant pastor said the same thing. Herbert Scheibel remains in jail, but Catherine Scheibel has been released to live with her parents. The remaining children are in state custody.
Ms. Scheibel, do you feel you did right by God?
No comment.
This is Herbert Scheibel's attorney.
He's sad. He's still in a grieving mode. I looked at him this morning. He seemed to have lost weight. But in terms of holding up, he's a stand-up guy.
Certainly, that's a most controversial characterization. We wanted to show you pictures of Herbert and Catherine Scheibel's 2 little boys. But lawyers on both sides say they don't know of any pictures of them in life. All they have are their autopsy photos, taken shortly before they were buried in their unmarked graves.
A lot of people say you have no love for your child because you've let 2 children die without medical help.
No comments.
And Gary Tuckman joins us now live from Philadelphia. Gary, this is so upsetting. How did it play out in court today?
Well, Anderson, in Pennsylvania, you have to have evidence of malice to charge third-degree murder. So in this courthouse today, the 2 different attorneys for the husband and the wife told the judge there's no malice, there should be no third-degree murder charge. But the judge totally rejected that. He said that this isn't even a close case. He pointed out the case of their first son dying and that they basically thumbed their nose at the law. And he says those third-degree murder charges will stand, and they face the possibility, husband and wife, of 20 to 40 years in prison if found guilty of that.
And were they in court together?
They were in court together. He's in jail, like we said. She's out on bond. She was sitting in the back when he walked in. He walked in, he looked around, saw her, smiled at her. She just looked straight ahead, but it was a weird dynamic in the court. Her father was sitting next to her, and he smiled at his son-in-law. A very strange and horrible situation.
And they have other children. All the other children are what, in foster care?
7 other children are in the foster care system right now, and that reassures a lot of people that those children are no longer with those parents.